the other end down there. What's going on?
Good to see you, man.
Long time no see.
Long time. Good to see you, man.
See you.
You got old. Me too.
Yeah. Well, beats the shit out of the alternative, doesn't it? I'd rather be young than, or rather be old than
6 feet under.
Yeah. Old and dead.
Say hello to Mom.
Hi, Mom. Cerveza is bueno.
Just listed that came on the market. He's going to show us that. I mean, from the pictures on the internet, I'm really not that. It's a Victorian home, which is kind of funny to see a Victorian home in Steamboat.
But it's a new Victorian home.
Yeah.
Made, designed to look, you know, old. It's not. Whereas me, I'm designed to look young, but.
Say cheese.
Cheese!
I've got the cheese between my teeth on that one. All the dogs we've ever had are here this far and come down here and right down there. We've had three dogs that you've never met that have come and gone. All got to do.
Fight Mother Nature too much up here. Mother Nature always wins.
That's beautiful.
May just be that he loves the belly rub. I don't know. But I think he walks better when I do this. There you go. He's got a big titanium plate in his left knee. Busted his teeth out on the fence like this. Sammy, Samster.
Is that a fig tree?
It's a crabapple tree.
Oh, okay. Beautiful.
Got hit by hail really hard a few times this year.
It's beautiful.
It's definitely warmer here than it.
Realize that it will stop you very quickly.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
And the shifting on this, now, the shifting is just like motorcycle twist.
Yeah.
You can't really screw it up too much. So do you know, does this shift like your bike where it,
yeah
rear and the front, it's got two chain rings on front instead of three. It doesn't matter which gear you're in up here, which gear you're in back there, it'll all work.
Uh-huh.
And you shouldn't have to in between shift, you know, if you shift it, you're not going to hear noise of the chain rubbing or anything too much. It should it should be all perfect.
Okay.
You might want to check seat height. I've got it set for me and we're about the same height, so you should be close.
All right.
I can adjust this in 10 seconds if you want. I can give you a tool to take this to adjust it if you're comfortable with it where it is, or if you want me to raise it or lower it a little bit. I wouldn't mind if you rode up and down the street just for a second and made sure the seat's good, because they don't have the seat adjustment tool in here right now. I took it out for a particular reason.
Yeah.
But the only other thing on this, because it is a full suspension bike, I've got the suspension set on a mid setting, so you have some suspension, and in the rear too. So you can go over curbs, you can do anything you want, it's indestructible.
Okay.
And when you set it on full, where you go over here, when you have all these adjustments for, then you get, you know, massive amounts of travel. You can go off cliffs with this thing and not break it.
Well, but I'm gonna try to stick to the roads today.
Right.
So.
In order to go faster, you don't want it to be all mushy.
Yeah.
So now you can go full lockout where it's more rides like a hardtail, meaning it doesn't have any suspension. Do you want
to
have a little bit of suspension
no.
in it? Okay, so we'll leave it in the middle
suspension.
Setting. I wouldn't touch these. I air up the shocks. I've got all the gauges and shit. I sometimes fine-tune these things to it. And then these are designed for clip-in, but the nice thing about these is you can just pedal on them, you know, without having to worry about
it. You took off the clips.
Well, it's actually designed to have a cleat on the bottom of your shoe that you snap in.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, yeah.
So it's not really like a cage. Like,
I was thinking of the cage type thing.
Yeah, yeah, so you're not going to be able to pull as much. It'll be more of a push motion, but you're not going for speed anymore.
No, no, no. Okay.
Do you want to just ride just a second and try? So, the only thing...
Hey, cheese, man.
Cheese. Oh, God, they look like dog meat, I'm sure.
So, the only thing what?
The only thing that I don't like about doing it this way is, unless you pre-cook the meat, which I don't like to do, like some people do, but you have to take these in and cut this up and put them in the tacos. But, small price to pay for having it fresh.
Mm-hmm.
And then, this is a little bit hotter than it should be for these shows. Decent attention.
Wow.
These are Japanese taco shells.
Really?
Japanese pork.
Are you sure
you're filming?
Nice.